The first thing to do when you're doing a soil texture by feel is to make sure that you separate out all the organic materials and stones from the soil, because when we're measuring soil texture, what we're doing is we are measuring the mineral sizes, not the organic matter. The reason why you get rid of stones is because stones are bigger than 2 millimeters in diameter, and that's the largest size of sand particle that we consider to be soil. When doing a finger assessment of soil texture, it's important to use a flow chart of some sort to help guide you along the way. In this case, this first page says start, and then it says sand content determination. In order to determine the sand content, you take a small amount of soil, put it in the palm of your hand, oversaturate it with water, and rub it with your finger. If it feels very gritty, it has more than 50% sand, and if it does, if there's just a little bit of grit or no grit at all, then you have less than 50% sand. That will determine which flowchart and which page to use. If you determine you have less than 50% sand in your sample, then you would use this flowchart. With this flowchart, where it says less than 50% sand on the right-hand side, you're going to go from the right towards the left. There are 4 tests you do. There is the moist cast test, the feel test, and the ribbon test. And that will allow you to figure if the soil is anywhere from a sandy clay to a sand soil. If you have determined that there is less than 50% sand in your sample, in my case, I would use this page. On this page, I start at the left where it says sand content determination, less than 50% sand, and then I go through the various feel tests. There is the moist cast test, the ribbon test, the feel test, the taste test, and the shine test. Generally, we do not do the taste test anymore because the bacteria and other organisms in soil have the potential to make you very sick, and in some cases even kill you. And so doing the taste test is not recommended anymore. Besides, you never know what has been applied to the surface of the soil. It could have had manure applied, and nobody wants to eat that anyway. What I like to do when I'm getting a soil ready for soil texture by feel is to add water a little bit at a time. In this case, there's a lot of soil there, so we've got lots of water to add. But add water until the paper towel or the palm of your hand, if you're doing the palm of your hand, starts to get wet. Okay. In this case, it looks like the soil is a little hydrophobic, so I'll add a little bit more than you would normally add. You have to get your hands dirty and get right in there and mix up the soil well. And as you mix it, we want to break up all the aggregates that are there, as well as making sure that everything is nice and wet and moist, adding water as necessary. Eventually, because the soil was from a forest and was air dry, all the aggregates were broken down and we finally got a nice ball of soil to work with. People often ask what consistency the soil should be in when you're doing the soil texture by feel. And the soil should be wet enough that it moves easily, but not so wet that water is dripping out. In this case, there is really no water showing up on the paper towel, and that would be about the right amount of water. All the aggregates are broken up, and the soil is holding together. Because this soil has very little sand in it, and it has less than 50% sand, and therefore it's medium or fine textured, then it holds together quite easily. The first test you do is a moist cast test. And with a moist cast test, you take the soil in your hand and you squeeze it and you see if it holds together. This is a cast. Okay? So if the soil holds together, it forms a cast. Then you have to decide what how strong the cast is. So there are weak casts, very weak casts, moderate, strong, and very strong. A weak cast, if you poke with a little bit of pressure, will fall apart. A moderate cast, you can poke it fairly strongly and it will not fall apart. A strong cast, if you poke it like that and it falls apart, then that would be a strong cast. A very strong cast, if you poke it, would stick together. The next test is the ribbon test. So what you do is you take your cast and you make it into a more elongated cigar shape if you can, like I'm doing now. And once you get that cigar shape, what you want to do is between your thumb and your index finger, your thumb and your index finger, what you're going to do is you're going to take the cast and you're going to squeeze it with your thumb over your index finger. And as you go, you add more soil from further back and you see how long a ribbon you can make. In this case, I made a ribbon that was 3 centimeters long, which means that this soil has a moderate ribbon. And so it ribbons a little bit. It does stick together. Another thing that you look for when you're doing a cast and the ribbon test is how much soil sticks to your hand. In this case, the soil was relatively sticky, so it stuck to my hand. The feel test is when you take some of the soil, take a pinch of soil between your thumb and your finger, you don't need much, and you rub it. And what you're feeling for are one of 3 sensations. You're feeling for grittiness, which means there's lots of sand. You're feeling for a nice, smooth, floury feel, which means it's got lots of silt, or you feel really nothing at all, and that indicates lots of clay. So what you want to do is you want to keep rubbing until that pinch of soil literally disappears from between your fingers, and there's a little bit of grittiness there, but mostly that was a floury feel, so that indicates that there's a fair bit of silt in this particular soil. The last test we're going to do is called the shine test. So I'm going to take the soil, make it into more of a ball. That's just kind of makes the shape easy to work with. And then I'm going to find something really smooth. And so what's really smooth? Well, the tabletop's smooth enough. If you're out in the field, usually you use a knife. But in this case, the tabletop's fine. So with a little bit of pressure, you push down and you drag the soil across the really smooth surface, flip it over, and see if you can see any kind of a shine coming off that particular soil. In this case, there's a slight to moderate shine coming off the soil. That indicates the presence of clay. Soils that have lots of clay, remember clay particles are shaped like sheets of paper, and so when you drag it across that smooth surface, you line up those clay plates all in the same direction. And so the reason why you drag it across something smooth is to line up the clay plates. That means there's a very flat surface that's reflective, and the light reflects off that surface. In this case, we have a slight to moderate shine that indicates a bunch of clay in this particular soil. Those are the different tests you use when you're trying to figure out the soil texture by feel. Now, it's not 100% accurate. It doesn't need to be 100% accurate. Because if you say a soil is a clay loam, but in reality it's a silty clay loam, usually that's close enough. Especially when we're dealing with agriculture, where you just have a very small sample of the field. And so you would say it's a silt loam, and it's actually a loam, again, close enough. Now, where we start running into trouble is if you say it's a sandy loam, but in reality it's a clay loam, then those soils behave very, very differently, and that's not close enough. But if you say it's a clay loam, but it's actually a loam, then that's close enough because the management for a clay loam is similar to the management for a loam soil. If you were following along as we did the sample, you would find that we had a strong cast, we had a thin supports its own weight ribbon, we had a moderate graininess and a sticky sample for the feel test. We did not do the taste test, and we had a slight shine. And so that means the soil that we looked at, that we did a soil texture by feel on, is a clay loam soil. If you were to go through and do the same sample and determine that the soil was a silty clay loam, that is close enough. Clay loam and silty clay loam are side by side, and the management of each is very similar, so you don't have to be perfect, but you do have to be close. Soil texture by feel is a very quick, easy way of determining the texture of a soil. It gives accurate enough results to use those results for management of a soil.